What's good, Dub Nation? You're watching Warriors Today by Chat Sports, and on today's show, we're going to be answering your questions. We put out a post in our YouTube community tab earlier today, actually, and you guys already got back to us with a number of really great questions surrounding your Golden State Warriors and the rest of this offseason, what will happen in the near future, what is the outlook on Golden State looking like this season. We're going to answer all that, dive into all the questions in just a moment. But before we do, if you guys want to be alerted every single time we post a video here on the channel, if it is a breaking news segment, you're not going to want to miss it. So make sure you're alerted by going down there next to the subscribe button and tapping that bell icon. That way you'll turn on notifications, and make sure when you turn those notifications on, you set them to all. So anytime you put a piece of content out here on the channel, you are alerted. And when you do that, type Noti Gang down in the comments to make sure that I know you are have your notifications turned on. And we'll get started with today's mailbag video. All right, first question coming in from Andy Sauro. Andy, what do you want to know? He says, how will Steve Kerr manage minutes this season to ensure that we give our youth playing time and start a center? Hashtag Warriors. Interesting thought, Andy, because the Warriors, they're in a weird situation right now. They kind of have an embarrassment of riches when it comes to mid-tier depth on this roster, right? You go out in free agency and you sign Buddy Hield, Kyle Anderson, and D'Anthony Melton. And in my opinion, those types of moves are ones you make when you're, you know, trying to take the next step from mid-tier contender to top-tier contender. But if you look at this Warriors starting five right now, Steph Curry, Brandon Pajemski, Andrew Wiggins, Draymond Green, Jonathan Kuminga. Can anybody really tell me who the secondary scoring option is next to Stephen Curry? Now, to be fair, pundits at ESPN actually think the Warriors are looking to be improved this season. But if you look at that bench there with Buddy Hield, Moses Moody, D'Anthony Melton, Gary Payton II, who accepted his player option, Kyle Anderson, who you signed for a three-year deal, Trey Jackson Davis, who's a young player, and then you got guys like Quinn Post, who they just drafted this year. There's a lot of room. I mean, there's not a lot of room in this rotation right now, and Steve Kerr is going to have to figure that out, because with the mantra that they're using right now with this new era of youth, they're going to have to probably start Brandon Pajemski. You're going to have to start Jonathan Kuminga, because those are guys you didn't give up to make a big swing deal for a Paul George or a Lauren Markkanen. So then a guy like Moses Moody kind of, you know, falls out of a potential rotation because you signed and paid money to Buddy Hield, Kyle Anderson, D'Anthony Melton. Now, Hield and Melton of the three there are going to be in Moody's spot. So Steve Kerr is going to have to figure something out there. It might have to be a trial by error kind of scenario early on in the season. See what lineups work, see what's meshing, and see, you know, who's trying to have the biggest bite. Who's the hungriest dog that's trying to assert themselves as a solid position on this roster? The Warriors have a ton of log jams going on at multiple positions, at the guard, the two guard, and the wing position. So it's going to be very difficult for Steve Kerr to figure it out. But I'm confident in the talent that Golden State has on this roster right now to be able to figure that, you know, rotation out. Next one coming in from our guy, Cade Jackson. He says, hashtag Warriors, do you honestly have faith in Mike DUNLEAVY Jr. with the way he has handled losing so many opportunities to make our team better? We don't seem to have a plan. Shout out to Chase and Smitty. Shout out to Chase Sr. as well. And shout out to you, Cade, for asking a hard-hitting question like this. Honestly, I do have faith in Mike DUNLEAVY Jr., but it's kind of capped a little bit, right? Because he hasn't made that big swing deal that has improved this roster and vaulted them to contender status, right? If you look back at his deals he made before this offseason, you know, sending Jordan Poole away, a guy you gave $40 million to, a young ascending star who I know wasn't gelling great in the locker room, but you send him away for Chris Paul, who ends up leaving a year later. And you also send a draft pick away because you thought the Jordan Poole contract was so bad. It might be, but now you're left with nothing as a part of that deal. And a pick down the line in 2030 is headed to Washington. So I haven't not much faith in his, you know, trade department, but with the free agency moves that he brought in, I'm encouraged a bit. I think they fit the Warriors system very well, especially Kyle Anderson. We'll talk about that in a little bit as well. But it's one of those situations where, you know, maybe nothing has been presented to Mike DUNLEAVY yet. Maybe he's actually just waiting out for the big fish to go out and make a big swing deal for this Warriors roster. So at the end of the day, I'm not, you know, losing faith in Mike DUNLEAVY, especially with what he's been able to draft and Brandon Pajemski and Trace Jackson Davis. And, you know, those two young players are very encouraging to me. So as far as a player development standpoint, I do have faith in Mike DUNLEAVY, and hopefully you do too. I want to get a pulse from the Dub Nation here. Like this video, go down below and hit the thumbs up icon if you still have faith in Mike DUNLEAVY. You see the vision of what he wants with this Golden State roster, this new youth movement, and hopefully, eventually, making a big swing deal down the line. Like this video if you still have faith in the Warriors GM. YoungWest79 coming in with the next one. He said, hashtag Warriors, who do you think will contribute the most this season between DeAnthony Melton, Buddy Hield, and Kyle Anderson? These are the three players that Golden State has brought in free agency this year, and they all expect to be big members of this rotation. But starting with DeAnthony Melton, in my opinion, there's a caution sign on him because he only played 38 games last year, and that injury that he missed a ton of time with was a back injury, and that's something that scares me, to be quite honest. As somebody who's not 30 years old yet, still in, you know, the prime of his career relative, you know, but he's got a big injury question mark on him right now. Buddy Hield, on the other hand, I got a lot of faith in. He's going to fill into that Klay Thompson role. Not a great defender, not somebody who's going to take it off the dribble too much, but really at this point in his career, was Klay Thompson that guy? Not really. So Buddy Hield's going to come in and be a sniper for Golden State. But somebody who I'm really looking forward to watching in this Golden State system is Kyle Anderson. I think he's really going to really mold well under Draymond Green, being able to be that facilitator from the 3-4 spot, you know, playing out of the high post, dishing out to players on the wing, and, you know, being able to put the ball in the bucket when necessary. Also, Kyle Anderson has always been a part of top-tier defenses. I don't think that's, you know, necessarily a coincidence. Kyle Anderson knows how to be a great team defender, and I'm very excited for how he's going to help transform the Warriors' second unit on the defensive end as well. I think he's a two-way player, and the Warriors got him on a very good deal. I'm excited for all three of these guys to be a part of this Warriors roster this season, but I want to hear from you. Who is going to be the most productive out of these three guys right here? If it's Buddy Hield, type BH. If it's DeAnthony Melton, type DM. If it's Kyle Anderson, type KA. I want to hear from Dub Nation on who you think is going to be the best free agency signing of the bunch. We're going to get into a couple more questions in just a second. But before we do, got to make sure you guys are hooked up with this fresh deal right here. The 2024 Paris Olympic Championship t-shirt. You can find it right here at chatsports.com/teamusa. They got our boy Steph front and center next to LeBron. Don't miss out. I'm going to get myself one to rock here on the show as well. Go use that link yourself. chatsports.com/teamusa. I'm going to make it easy for you guys. I'm going to put that link in the comments and description of today's video. So go get yourself swagged out with some Team USA merch right now. Next one coming in from Sting, back from WWE. Okay, all right. This is a little bit of a Warriors hot take here, I believe. He says, Joe Lacob and DUNLEAVY Jr. say they already turned the page on the Curry era and building their future around Pods and Kuminga. They want to trade Curry, but don't want to take the heat. So Curry is just going to stay here to sell tickets. Hashtag Warriors. That is a scorching hot take, but it's not one that I necessarily think doesn't have legs. I think there's a solid chance here that Mike DUNLEAVY, the Warriors front office, is maybe okay sitting on their laurels and ushering in the next era of Warriors basketball and not really placing a priority on trying to win Steph Curry his fifth championship at this time. You know, they could have potentially thrown away Brandon Pajemski in a deal for Lauri Markkanen. And would I have done it? Probably. As far as vaulting Golden State to championship status right now, I would have sent Brandon Pajemski away. I don't think Brandon Pajemski can be a second or third best player on a championship team with Steph Curry for the rest of the, you know, in the twilight of his career. So I don't hate this hot take. I don't necessarily think it's true, though. I do think that Golden State and their front office believe that they're well positioned to still make a big trade this season in order to be a championship roster. They know, this front office knows, that they're not a championship roster right now. And only time will tell. If we go through this season and no move is made, and Stephen Curry is, you know, probably pretty upset come next offseason, yeah, I'm going to believe this hot take. And you know what? You're going to have a feel really vindicated that it comes to fruition if there's no big swing deal made. But I do think that the front office is going to attempt to improve this roster. Last question coming in from San Fran 20158, San Fran Man 30, saying, hashtag Warriors, what player puts us at contender status again and can help us get another ring for Steph and Draymond? All right, we're throwing Draymond in there. Well, funny thing about Draymond is he did say that he probably only has 2 years left in his NBA career. So is this a two-year window for Steph and Draymond in the twilight of their careers? I think there's one player that can get them to championship status. And it's Giannis Antetokounmpo. I know he's not getting traded. The Bucks are never going to trade Giannis. But I saw the idea floated out yesterday by Paul Pierce, saying that, you know, obviously he didn't have any inside source, and we know that Giannis isn't getting traded from Milwaukee, but what he could do for this Warriors team is paramount. I mean, it would probably be the best duo in the NBA, even if Steph Curry, you know, played all the way until he was 42. Giannis and Steph would be the best duo in the NBA, bar none. Now, the one concern I do have with Giannis is, we saw it in this past postseason, is the health, obviously, with just nagging injury stuff. There's never been anything too major with Giannis, but he always is missing a couple of games here. But last season, the regular season-wise, man, 30 points a game. 30-point double-double on 60% shooting has never been done in this league before. And, I mean, what a specimen Giannis is. A guy who's already won a championship, can usher in the next era of Warriors basketball, and can maximize Steph Curry's final years of his career. Giannis is probably the only player that, if you just added him to this roster, I think vaults them immediately into championship contender status at the top of the Western Conference. But that's just me. What do you guys think? Is there anybody else? Is there anybody else out there that the Warriors could trade for? I know that they probably couldn't trade for Giannis, but is there anybody out there for a fantasy dream scenario that if you just add him next to Steph Curry on this roster, obviously giving you the trade some pieces as well, makes the Warriors a contender right now? Let me know down in the comments, who's the guy, not who's your guy, who's the guy that makes Golden State a championship contender this second? I want to hear from Dub Nation. Let me know down in the comments. And that'll do it for today's Golden State Warriors Q&A mailbag. We answer your questions on this channel every single week, so make sure you are subscribed and turn notifications on so you make sure whenever we post a community post like that asking for your questions, you guys can go down there, put hashtag Warriors in, ask away, and get on the show. YouTube.com/WarriorsTV to never miss a moment around your Golden State Warriors. We'll see you in the next one. Let's go, Dubs.